Students, I, Mrs. Neeta Ivle, once again welcomes you. We have started second chapter of bookkeeping and accountancy. Now today, we are going to understand accounting equation. Friends, we understood classification of accounts, traditional approach and modern approach of accounting, also got familiar with golden rules. Now we understood methods of recording information. There are two approaches to record accounting information. First is traditional approach and modern approach. Now we also understood the classification of accounts according to traditional approach and also modern approach. We studied that in traditional approach, we can classify the accounts in two groups, that is personal account and impersonal accounts. Also further we classify impersonal accounts in real accounts and nominal accounts. Sabko yaad hai, humne ye sab padha hai. Now we are just recalling them, okay? Under modern approach, we also classify the accounts. We classify accounts in five groups here, five categories in here. Assets, liabilities, capital, revenue and gains and expenses. We also studied the golden rules for both the approaches where we can give debit and credit to the accounts. And in this way, we have studied all the process, all the system of recording accounting information under these two approaches. Right? Now what next? Today, we are going to understand accounting if equation. Now students, you must have aware that these all are the foundation of accounting. That is the base for whole accounting system. That is why they should be understood properly. The fundamental accounting equation, also called the balance sheet equation, represents the relationship between the assets and liabilities of a person or a business. It is the foundation for the double entry bookkeeping system. For each transaction, the total debits equal the total credits. Right? Total debit or total credit equal hone chahiye. This is the basic foundation of double entry bookkeeping system. Since every business transaction affects at least two of the company's accounts, the accounting equation will always be in balance. Hamesha equation jo hai balance hona chahiye, accounting equation. In other words, the left hand side of its balance sheet should always equal to the right side. Thus, the accounting formula essentially shows that what the firm's assets and what are its liabilities, also what its owners invested. Thus, all situation or we can say financial position will be shown in the accounting equation. The accounting equation plays a significant role as the foundation of the double entry bookkeeping system. The primary aim of the double entry system is to keep track of debits and credits and ensure that the sum of these always matches up to the company assets, a calculation carried out by the accounting equation. It is based on the idea that each transaction has an equal effect. It is used to transfer totals from books of primary entry into the nominal ledger. Every transaction is recorded twice so that the debit is balanced by a credit. Okay, now we will see what is the actual accounting equation is there. In the formation of accounting data, a basic accounting equation is used for financial statement. No matter if you are just a small business or a multi-million company. Dono ke liye bhi, chota business ho aapka ya bada business ho, ये जो अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन जो दिया हुआ है वो बेसिक है और फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट के लिए वो एक बेस प्रोवाइड करता है. नाउ इन द इटालियन मैथमेटिशियन लुका पैसिओली फॉर्मुलेटेड ए बेसिक अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन फॉर्मूला इन 1494 इन हिज वर्क ए ट्रीटीज ऑन अकाउंट्स एंड रिकॉर्ड्स. फ्रेंड्स, आपको नाम याद है ये और ईयर भी याद होगा. फर्स्ट लेक्चर में मैंने आपको बताया था कि लुका पैसिलियो ने ही हमें डबल एंट्री बुक कीपिंग सिस्टम इंट्रोड्यूस की है व्हेन इन 1494. डोंट फॉरगेट दैट. एंड ऑन 10th नवंबर ही इंट्रोड्यूस दिस सिस्टम टू द वर्ल्ड. सो द डे इज सेलिब्रेटेड एज इंटरनेशनल अकाउंटिंग डे विच इज 10th नवंबर. ओके, अकाउंटिंग सिस्टम्स ऑफ ऑल कंट्रीज आर बेस्ड ऑन द यूज ऑफ दिस बेसिक अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन. वर्चुअली एवरी बिजनेस ट्रांजेक्शन टू बी रिफ्लेक्टेड इन अकाउंटिंग कैन बी फॉर्मुलाइज्ड विद इन द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन और विद इन इट्स सेवरल वेरिएशंस. द बेसिक फॉर्मूला इज एज फॉलोज. Assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. Now, what is assets? You know, friends, what is assets? Assets are the properties, the belongings of the business. What is liabilities? Liabilities are payables of the business. And what is capital? Capital is the amount or assets which the owner is going to invest in his business. So, ये जो three things है, ये three things से ही हमें पता चलता है financial position of the business. If you want to understand financial position of any business, you have to see or you will check these three things and you will automatically or immediately you will get the idea about the business. Which three things? Assets, liabilities and capital. Okay. Let's take a look at following example of the accounting equation and analyze each entry in it. After completing a transaction and totaling the accounts on each side, you can see that the numbers are equal after each transaction, which means that the balance sheet is balanced. जो अभी हम एक एग्जाम्पल लेंगे और उसमें जो दो तीन ट्रांजेक्शन्स दिए हुए हैं वो हम लोग सॉल्व करेंगे. यू विल फाइंड दैट कि हर एक ट्रांजेक्शन के बाद टोटल ऑफ ईच साइड, डेबिट साइड सॉरी लेफ्ट हैंड साइड और राइट हैंड साइड की टोटल सेम आने वाली है. दैट मीन्स एवरी टाइम द बैलेंस शीट इज बैलेंस्ड हियर. नाउ सी द प्रॉब्लम, सी द क्वेश्चन. गिव द अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन फॉर द फॉलोइंग ट्रांजेक्शन्स. There are three transactions. First is Mohini started a business with cash ₹60,000. Second one is Mohini purchased a computer from Patil and Company on credit of ₹20,000. And third one is Mohini purchased goods ₹25,000. We will see how the equation works for us. Now let's have the first transaction, that is Mohini started a business with cash ₹60,000. The accounting equation is as follows. Assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. First of all, we will write the equation and then we will solve the problem. आपने 10th में भी अलजिब्रा में यही किया था ना, हमेशा आप लोग पहले फॉर्मूला लिखते थे, after that you go to solve the example. Like that, first we write the equation, that is assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. Now see, with this transaction, that means Mohini started a business with cash 60,000. What is happening in the business? Now the cash is coming in the business and Mohini is the owner, and if she is bringing cash in the business, that will considered as capital. So assets and capital will increase. So we will write here cash is equal to capital plus liabilities. Now, cash is an asset. So, instead of asset, I wrote there cash. Now, see, the amount of capital is rupees 60,000 and it is in the form of cash. So, I write left hand side 60,000 is equal to what is capital 60,000 plus 0. What is 0? It is liabilities. Right now, she don't have any liabilities. So, put there just 0. So, 60,000 is equal to 60,000 plus 0. If you see right hand side and left hand side, you will get 60,000, right? So, the equation is balanced here. Now, move to the second transaction. That is, Mohini purchased a computer from Patil and Company on credit rupees 20,000. What Mohini is doing here? Mohini is purchasing a computer. What is computer? Computer is an asset, right? And she is not giving cash for that. She is purchasing the computer on credit. You know that what is credit transaction. Credit transaction ka matlab hota hai, usne wo paise baad mein dene wali hai. Right now, she is just taking computer in the business, but she is not paying for that. She will pay in future. Kisko degi wo future mein? Patil and Company ko. So, Patil and Company will be her creditor. Now, the equation is assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. Here, assets abhi do ho gaye. First transaction mein asset tha cash and right now computer, the second asset. So, on left hand side, I wrote there cash plus computer is equal to capital to hai. So, capital plus liabilities are increased here. That means sundry creditors. Why sundry creditors? Because in this transaction, Patil and Company are creditors. Okay. Now what next? Cash is 60,000 that remains in the business as in the first transaction. Plus, what is the value of computer? That is 20,000. That means assets are 60,000 cash and 20,000 of computer. Is equal to capital. Is there in any change in capital? Not at all. So, capital remains 60,000. Plus, how many sundry creditors are there? How many Mohini will pay in future to Patil and Company? Rupees 20,000, right? So, plus 20,000. You will see on the left hand side, cash plus computer, that means 60,000 plus 20,000 is equal to capital plus creditors, that means 60,000 plus 20,000. What is the total of left hand side? Yes, 80,000. And what is the total of right hand side? It is also 80,000. So, you will see that the left hand side equals right hand side. That means again the equation is in balance. The third transaction is Mohini purchased goods rupees 25,000. Here, what Mohini is going to do? She is purchasing goods and paying cash for that rupees 25,000. Again, we will write the equation, that is assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. Assets, abhi kya kya hai? Cash and computer. Plus stock. Stock means goods, stock of goods. Equals capital plus sundry creditors. In second transaction, creditors are created there. Okay. Now see, as per the old balance, that means before the third transaction took place, 60,000 for cash plus 20,000 computer and plus stock was nothing there. So, we will put there 0 is equal to capital 60,000 and creditors 20,000. Now, this third transaction took place and the new transaction affect like this. 35,000 cash. Why cash goes down? Because we paid for purchases, that means goods. So 60,000 minus 25,000, that is 35,000. Then 20,000 computer, that remains the same, plus 25,000 stock, right? These are the assets. Right now, these are the assets in the business. Equals, capital is the same, that means 60,000, plus creditors are also remain the same, 20,000. Now, we will total both the sides. You will get left hand side 80,000 and also right hand side 80,000. So, again, the equation gives the same figure in right hand side and left hand side. Friends, in this way, you will find the numbers are equal after each transaction, which means that the balance sheet is balanced. Friends, today we understood accounting equation and its application. Hope you got all it. With this lecture, we have completed our second chapter of bookkeeping and accountancy, that is meaning and fundamentals of double entry bookkeeping system. Friends, you watched all the lectures of this lesson with great enthusiasm. At the same time, you have motivated me. I am very excited to meet you again in the following chapters. Thank you very much, friends, for being with me.